What's going on, guys? Hanging with me right now, I have the Amber Liu. Woo
woo! What's Amber, up, you guys?
What's up? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. So excited that you're here.
I'm excited that I'm on this very comfy couch.
You've been killing it for
Thank
so
you.
Long, and you recently just had a birthday.
Yes.
Right?
27 now.
Happy belated birthday, Virgo.
Thank you.
You know yes. you're a Virgo, right?
Me and a majority of my team are all Virgos, so it's pretty intense when we all disagree with each other, but
okay.
but we are also like perfectionists and like that we also need to agree with each other, so mm-hmm. we find a way.
Well, fun fact, I'm a Virgo, which is why I brought it up, because
yes!
I love Virgo Nation.
Yes.
So we shouldn't fight then, is basically what
yes.
we were just telling the audience. We don't want it yes. to get too intense, right?
Well, I heard later on we're doing something, so I don't know, maybe we have to get intense and, you know.
I mean, I love intensity. I just don't want to fight with you.
Okay.
This is our first meeting, you know what I mean?
That's true. I'll be nice this time.
Oh, God, I'm scared. Well, congratulations
Thank
again
you.
On all of your success thus far.
Thank you.
Most recently, your video for Hands
yeah.
Behind My Back.
Yes.
It's so cool.
Thanks.
I love it.
I actually, like, last minute drew a lot of inspiration from Jordan Peele's, like, Us. Like, you know,
oh,
that standing
yeah.
thing. I was like, that's how I felt. That's what it is. And we're doing that. I just been, like, trying to, like, you know, kind of let my inspirations inspire me rather than, like, being so like freaked out all the time and you know, I don't know, I panic for no apparent reason apparently.
Virgo stuff.
I get
it, I totally get it.
The world is ending and we haven't even, you know, said anything and it's gonna end.
At least that's what it feels like on the inside,
yes.
right? But I was gonna say, you directed
yeah.
it,
yeah.
which is awesome. And my favorite part is the end where your hands are, you know, behind
yeah.
you and it's just, you break free from it and it's so symbolic,
Dude,
which I love.
So I can't take credit for that. That was all the choreographer, Sora Yang, who's, you know, just been training me for the past like year and a half. I was telling Sora, I was like, yo, the song's about this. It's about this and this. Choreograph the way you want to choreograph it. Because like, that's what you're supposed to let the art do to you, like
right.
the music do to you. So honestly, the hardest part of the choreography was just actually me learning the lip syncs to it. Because I had to, it's like, it's on a walk. Trying to fight. It's weird. It took a long time, but I figured it out. In the end, she was like, you're gonna do this, you're gonna do this. And I'm like, whoa.
You guys are getting some insight what was happening on set.
No,
clearly.
No, it seriously was that. It was just like, oh, you made my song so cool.
You did say that that's how you felt.
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit more about like the inspiration and why you chose to go that way with the video?
You know, I feel like where the environment that I was in, mm-hmm. it was very, it's like, it's either you do it one way or you can't do it at all. So, you know, I'm pretty sure that's something that like a lot of people go through. And, you know, in the end, I just kind of felt like I saw things that I felt like weren't right. Not only in my own opinion, but like morally, it didn't felt right to like do certain things.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, so, you know, I felt like with the people that are holding me back, they also don't know what's going on while they're, you know, shutting me out. So, like, that's where the double meaning of hands behind my back comes from. It's like, you put my hands behind my back, but you also don't know what I'm doing behind my back.
Ooh, I like that.
So, backfire.
So, that's
yeah.
That's so cool.
I kind of wanted to also just give hope to people. Like, yeah, I'm like sad throughout the whole song, but you know, it's also telling people like in your power too, you can let those people go if you find a way. So yeah, anybody out there who's feeling what I'm feeling, you can get out of it and you can do what you want to do.
Preach, yes.
Yes.
That is inspirational.
I had the weird stutter and I was like, yeah.
But the message, it came through.
Yeah.
So the fans got you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
And you also recently announced that you have an album coming.
Yes.
So I know you can't tell us probably too much.
Yeah.
But I do want to know, what do you think or hope will be the fan favorite out of all the songs?
Well, so we had the listening party last week or around my birthday, and it was really interesting. So I personally, my favorite song is Other People.
Okay.
My team's favorite song is Curiosity. Even Crystal, my member from FX, her favorite song is Curiosity. A lot of people, my choreographer's favorite song is Numb. So it's like, it's kind of all around.
Mm-hmm.
But at the listening party, Ready for the Ride actually had like a, woo! It was like one of these. So, just, it wasn't what I was expecting, but yeah. You know, I think in the end, like, though I have a favorite, honestly, all the songs are very important to me. Mm-hmm. They're each like all stepping stones of like me becoming who I am and driving me to where, like, I guess I'm going toward now. If that made any sense, totally did not, but you guys get me.
It made sense.
Yeah. So, you know, I each holds a different part of me.
Yeah.
And I just hope that, you know, even if it's not your favorite, that maybe it's, like, you see the story that might be coming from it.
Right.
You know?
And songs grow on people too.
Yeah.
Right? So maybe some you just give a longer chance.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes. Hopefully.
Yes. Fingers crossed.
Yes.
You also have so many followers on all these platforms.
Yeah.
I know you're going to be a little modest and like shy right now, but you do have a lot. Millions
across.
You're making
me cringe a lot. So I'm just kind of like slowly just sinking down.
It's the truth though. So own it. Own it. But
yes, I have followers.
Yeah, you do.
I have followers.
We're going to get used to you saying that. Okay. By the end of this, you're going to say, I have followers and be so proud.
Okay. I'll try.
But the reason why I brought it up was because I want to know if you could DM anyone in the industry, any of your followers maybe, or just any artists, like who would it be and why? Also, what would you say for a collab, a hang sesh?
Well, on the flip side, Scott Ho-Ying from the Pentatonics actually reached out to me through DMs. Through my DMs. He slipped into my DM to collaborate with me on his Superfruit project with Mitch, and that was amazing. Anybody, right?
Yeah, anyone.
Bill Gates.
Wow, I was not expecting that.
I would want to DM Bill Gates.
What would you say?
Can I help your foundations? I don't know, like, I've just been like so like, you know, I stand a world climate supporter, you know, that like helps, you know, who's immensely successful in their field, and then they're just trying to find ways to give back to the community and to the world. Just like kind of like maybe when I get to maybe their status one day, what could I do with my money and what could I do to help the world? So yeah.
Wow, that's awesome.
Bill Gates, you awesome.
This is my favorite part of this whole thing. I want to get your dating advice.
Okay. Oh.
Because I feel like you're really good at it.
You're asking the wrong person.
No. Yeah. This is going to be so good. So I'm just going to give you a few scenarios, and you just have to tell me what you think I should do. What do you do when you're getting ghosted by someone you really like?
Forget the fool.
Yeah,
if they're ghosting you, then like, what, like, why spend any more time chasing after them?
All right, forget the foo.
Forget the foo.
All right, like that. What do you do when you have feelings for a friend and worry it will ruin the friendship?
Ooh, take it very slowly because I've had this too. So I would obviously try to, now that you've recognized that you've liked that person within your friend group, take it very slowly, like not act upon your crush, but try to see like how, I'm very analytical, how like, what ties with what, and then once you figure out like the pros and cons, is say you dating that so-and-so and breaking up, and them breaking up with you or you breaking up with them going to be worth it for the whole friend group?
Okay, so think a little bit on it.
Yeah.
Make sure it's what you want to do.
Yeah.
All right.
Especially with friends, you gotta be extremely, extremely like sensitive.
I agree with that. Yeah. All right, last one. Mm-hmm. What do you do when you screenshot a conversation with someone, you send it back to that same person?
I would just be all like, whoops, because yesterday I actually had sent out a mass copy-paste text to my friends because at the share links and blah, 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 blah.
Okay.
I write the text in my notes first, right? And I'm like, hey guys, copy-paste text alert, here you go, here's the information, here's the link, blah, 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 right? I select all, paste.
What happened?
It's like all copy, paste. I sent it all to my friends.
Oh my gosh.
It was a note that had a couple announcements, a coffee order, and a bunch of other information. And my friends obviously being total trolls, being all like, yeah, I would love that coffee. Yeah, blah, 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 blah. Oh, that date? Yeah, I'll totally be there. So I had to do another copy paste text saying, disregard the notes at the top.
Right? Copy and paste, it's risky.
Yeah.
It is risky. Clearly, you learned your lesson there, right, Amber?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, lastly, before you go, I do want to get your opinions on something. So, I think it's safe to say that, you know, the Asian culture has really been, you know, accepted and supported probably over recently the last, like, few years or so. You know, K-pop's blowing up, Asians in movies, taking lead roles. So, why do you think that is?
I think timing is a big thing, because I remember when I first got to K-pop, there were these like little, you know, like, I guess the equivalent of subreddit groups and all these forum groups supporting K-pop, but I think it just, the internet wasn't set up enough for the organization of these groups. And I think as times have, you know, like been passing and stuff, it's been getting better. And then now the mainstream has been catching on, you know, Psy hit, BTS hit, you know, now all the like Blackpink and like Twice, and everybody's like coming over. So yeah, it's awesome timing. I feel like, you know, with my generation that of growing up of second generation Asian Americans, our parents are all immigrants. So they are coming here not to pursue entertainment.
Right.
So because of their hard work and their sacrifices, my generation is able to, you know, explore different venues and different opportunities. And I think that's why we are able to, like, a lot of Asian, like, Americans are getting into film and stuff, because, you know, our parents are awesome.
Amber, you are truly amazing. Thank you so much for coming by. You're awesome.
Thank you for listening
Asians
to me
awesome.
Rant.
Music video is awesome. Yes. Guys, check it out. You don't want to miss her.
And Bill Gates.
Link up.
Yeah, and Mom and Dad, I love you.